Hi everyone, thanks so much for tuning in. So today's video we're going to be concluding with tarantula feeding video 135 part 3, the last part. We're just going to feature these two shells over here. It contains about 50 inverts, so I'm not sure if I'm going to feature them all, but I'll see which ones get good attacks. So again, as always, timestamps are on the video description. I'll also put another link on the video description because Sicarius terosus has another species name change. Not the genus. The genus is still Sicarius. However, terosus is a junior name, and it's synonymous with Thomisoides, because Thomisoides is the senior name, and that takes precedence over juniors. So Sicarius terosus is now called Sicarius Thomisoides. So I still have my little spiraling there. So without further ado, sit back and enjoy, and let's get started. All right, so now I believe we're on the 84th tarantula. This is Aphonopelma bicoloratum, the Mexican bloodleg. This is a juvenile female. Really nice job. Here's Albert, my male Brachypelma albiceps, the Mexican gold red rump male. Great attack. Very nice specimen. This one here is a Brachypelma angustum, which is the Costa Rican red-haired. I'll do my female first. Nice. I got two of these guys, so let's see this one again. All right, I spy the spider. Okay. Whoop. I don't think this one is interested in eating. All right, now let's try my Brachypelma erratum pair Mexican flame knees. This one is my female Brachypelma erratum, the Mexican flamey. This is a female named Ada. Resident Evil 2. Very similar coloration to the Smithy, except the highlighted difference is the flame tip knees, giving the common name Mexican flame knee. So that is the female, and we'll try to feed Leon. Leon's my male. Where is that guy? I know it's really not a tarantula name. Leon fits more like a lizard name. All right, let's see if he's gonna eat today. Beautiful. There he is. Raised him up ever since he was a half an inch spiderling about 6 years ago. Oh. This one is a female Brachypelma bumgartini, the Mocoan Orange Beauty from Mexico. Got some nice coloration. She's about 2.5 inches. See a little bald spot on her abdomen, but nothing really serious. If this is a true bumgartini, which I believe this could be, I would see the whole
carapace darkened like a beast smithy. I got this one from
Yili from Tarantulas in Canada Forum, the same guy I got for the Unknown Pokey and the Bicoloratum that you saw earlier in this part.
Okay, let's move on. Here's Melina. She is my Brachypalma Bomi, Mexican Far Lake female. I offered a super worm and she wasn't really taking it. Okay, I see you now. I see why.
Alright, sorry, Cricket. Guys, well, this is the fourth tarantula that is in pre-molt.
Like my Smithy and my Megaphobema Mazomalas, which I did not show on video. There's the bald spot that's darkened. Sweet! Can't wait to see how big she's gonna get.
Well, this is a nice tarantula. Basically, if you take the two tarantulas that I just featured, the B. Bumgartneyi and the B. Bomi, you marry them together and this is what you get as a product. This is called the Mexican Orange Beauty, Brachypalma Bumgartneyi cross Bomi. As you can see, typical characteristics of Brachypalmas: hungry eaters
and a little bit of hair kicking. A little bit, but not too bad. This one is Chimera,
from an awesome YouTuber that chose that name. Fits this one pretty well.
A little dark triangle on the carapace. It's not the true Bumgartneyi because they don't have the black carapace, the full one. But still, I'm not going to breed her. I'm just going to keep her just for a showpiece. A nice one.
Alright, let's try my female Brachypalma Emilia, the Mexican Painted Red Leg. This is an adult, 4.5 inches, which is the max size of these ones. Very gentle and slow. The Mexican brown tarantula, Brachypalma Kahlenbergi. This is Kali, for, I would say, a 5-inch female. A little bald spot in her abdomen.
Alright, let's feed her. Very similar coloration to B. vagans. But cool. There was a nice fang action going on here. Cool. Now to feed my last Brachy. They're classy. Very gorgeous female. I named her Petunia because she's pretty as a flower. Brachypalma Classy, which is the Mexican pink. So here we go. Whoop. I'm gonna give her 2. Nice, there's 1. Oh. You're not getting away. Nice spider. I'm gonna give her some water after this video. Okay, so that is all the Brachypalmas. Oh no, I did forget one more. Well, everyone, won't be able to feed this one. This is the last Brachypalma that I'll feature in my feeding video for this episode only. This is the Brachypalma vagans Mexican red rump. This is an unsexed spiderling that just recently molted. You can see that the colors are very vibrant and pretty much translucent, so this means that I won't be able to feed this one. But it's a nice job to see this one molt, and I would say this is about an inch right now. You can see the black legs starting to become apparent and the red hairs, which is typical of Brachypelma vagans, so showing its adult colors already.
Here's Kate, Catabena versicolor, and Tilly's pink toe. God, it's so weird calling this one Carabina and not Vicolaria, but anywho, that's the new name change.
Still a very happy, hungry, go-lucky tea. She's about, I would say, a good 2.5 inches. Adults will get up to having a 5-inch leg span. Love it. It's about time I updated her in my feeding videos. This is Cyclosternum species Macala, the Peruvian peach-collared Peachy Natasha. Not a very friendly tarantula. But we'll see if she's going to eat today for us. And I can say that she actually did. Nice job, sweetheart. A little bit skittish, but very, very temperamental.
Alright, up next is Talia. She is my Gramostola poteri female. This is the rose hair. We've seen Michaela eat in part one. Now, here's my second one. Nice. Hopefully gravid. I mated this girl along with Michaela with Roscoe. There was this mature male. Here's Angelica, my other Gramostola poteri. She's not so angelic because she isn't very friendly. But great eater, as always.
Hiya, Peter.
This is my Lois the redhead. From Family Guy, this is the red-faced rosehair, Gramostola rosea. I'm throwing in crickets because this is what Lois likes. She really doesn't like superworms. And that is it. Wow.
This is what she looks like. Amazing. It's good to see your rose hairs eat.
Here we have a 1/2 inch Hetiscodra maculata Toco starburst baboon.
Took well to a pin-sized cricket, aka pinheads. This one recently molted and so far it's growing really well. Right now I think that's about 3/4 of an inch now. But still a very good eater. Here's my other H. maculata. Cricket's gone. Yeah. HMAC says spiderlings, they tend to burrow, so keep them like your ordinary sling and you'll be fine with them. Alright, this one might be hard to see. This is one of the new ones I picked up from Tarantula Canada at the expo. Lampropelma species Borneo Black. Borneo Black, I believe. Oh, there is the sling. Oh, fantastic. Look at that. Like a champ. These guys are going to get to about 5.5 inches. Not as big as the Lampropelma vallisoiops, but they're really going to get a nice big black color, like Gramostola pulchra, Brazilian black. This here is Willow. She is my female Lasiodora fracta, the Brazilian smoky gray bird eater. 4.5 inch female. Nice slam dunk. Nice. Necroth's turn. This is my Lasiodora kluge male, Bahia scarlet bird eater.
Nope. You be dead. Swipe him clean. Yeah.
Yeah, he's about good 4 inches. And hopefully when he matures, I'll be pairing them up with both Marissa and Kana, which is my other El Kluge, the younger one. So he's good. Alright, this one is Daniela, my Lasiodora parahybana salmon pink bird eater. So she's about 5 inches. See how well she does. Oh, nice! Catch me outside! How about that? Well, that was weird. We'll give one more to her. Because she could use the extra pounds.
Shh! Don't say it. Don't tell her I said that.
Yep. A nice girl. Raised ever since she was a 1/2 inch spiderling. They grow really quickly when fed well.
Okay, so it's been a while since you last seen this one. I had suspicion that she would molt because she covered up herself in her entrance to her cave. So lo and behold, she molted and she looks really, really nice. This is, I believe, to be a female Megaphobema robustum, which is the Colombian giant red leg. This is the one that gets up to having an 8-inch leg span. Really hot looking species, and one of the more common ones of the Megaphobema genus. So let's see how she does with a super. Bada bing, bada boom. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I'm hot tonight. This is a gorgeous, gorgeous tea. That's where all of those spiny urticating hairs are. On her hind legs. Ah, the also inspiring female Monocentropus balfouri, which is the Socotra Island blue leg baboon. Yeah, there's Haley chirping away. Take a nice gander of my nice 5-inch female that I got from T-Soy Spiders back in 2012. So I had her for about 5 years now. Doing really well, and
a nice pet hole she is. This one here is Nandu Carapauensis, Brazilian Red. That's a great eater, but that's very typical of Nandu species. This one gets around having a 5-inch leg span. Unsexed, so not sure if it's female or male yet. I'll have to wait and see until I get a good molt out of this one. Here's Mina, a female Nandu Colorado villosus, the Brazilian black and white. Doesn't matter if you're black or white. There we go. What a pig. Love the Nandu species. Nandu tripepi female. This is the giant blonde bird eater, or strawberry blonde bird eater. This is the largest of the Nandu that get up to having a 8-inch leg span. So let's see how she does. Oh, nice. There we go. Booyah. Not the most colorful of the Nandus, but certainly the largest. Alright, let's try an unsexed and try Peppy. Yeah. Hits like a ton of bricks. This one's about 1.5 inches. A little smaller than the one that you just seen. This one is Geneva, newly named Orthonoctonus orotibalius female. This is the Thailand fringe. Made a Mythbuster video on this particular species. Very similar to the former Haplopelma, now Sargopagus. Great eater. Next up, another one I got from Tarantula Canada at the expo is an Orthonoctonae species Hattie Hattie, formerly Sargopagus, Sumatran blue. Nice. Not sure if you can actually make out the specimen. She's right over here where my thumb is pointing to. 1/2 inch. Well, I should say 3/4 now. Alright, this one here is Pamphibedia species chicken spider. Chicken eating spider. This is the one that is supposedly sexed to be male. He might be in pre-molt. So I'm just going to leave it in for a day and see if he accepts it. If not, then I'll remove it. No. We don't want a fourth escapee. Let's close you up. But I do want to show you my female, or my suspicion this could be female. This one just molted. I mean, look at the obvious difference colors between the molt, which is on the right, and the real spider on the left. So I'll give her about a week, and then I'll just make a little separate feeding video for this one here. Cool. Well,
Don Manuel, he is a male Formictopus auratus, which is the Cuban bronze. He's about 4 inches.
Oh, nice. Nice slam attack from the villager from Resident Evil 4. Really nice gold carapace with purple red abdomen. Nice species that's going to get up to 6.5-7 inches.
Alright, so now we're moving on to Pokies. So the first Poke I'm going to feature for this part is Pocotheria species Barra, which is the ivory lowland ornamental, the lowland form of Cefusca, which happens to be my favorite spider, tarantula. This one is about 1.5 inches. Next up is a P. formosa, Salem ornamental.
Beautiful attack.
And let's not forget to feature Sebastian's future wife. This is my female Hanmavilla sunica,
Ramashworm ornamental. Nice job, look at her. She's absolutely gorgeous. There we go. Yeah, she's about 3.5 inches.
Here's another P. formosa I got at the November Reptile Expo. This is my female P. formosa.
Haha! Nice, look at that. Can ask for a perfect attack. Sweet.
Here is Sebastian, my male Pocotheria hanmavilla sunica, the Ramashworm ornamental.
Wow, just yoink. It's the very first one that I bought in 2011. Getting really fat. Nice. Species of all time, Pocotheria cefusca. This is the Highland, Candy Highland ornamental. Go. Just look at the colors on them. Easy to see why I love this particular Pokey, because it's very differently colored than that of P. regalis.
This one is a true Speedy Gonzales. This is my unsexed specimen of Pocotheria tigrina wesseli, which is the Wessel Tiger ornamental. You've seen this one eat well in my first part of the video. So let's see how my little spiraling does. Boosh! Here we go, crazy fast species. Gotta love it. This one here a female Somapois Erminia, Venezuelan sun tiger.
Female named Josie. Okay, so you saw one quick super gone under her belly. So let's see the second one. Well, she's gonna take it. She's about 5 inches. Alright, I removed the second super worm. She's obviously not interested in two of them. This is definitely a must-have in your collection. Once again, Somapois Erminia, Venezuelan sun tiger. This is pretty much the adult size, like around 5.5 inches. This one here is a Triniopelma sasime. Brazilian iridescent blue. I got two of these guys right over here. Oh, well, if you can see this one, the bluish black bald spot characteristic of a pre-molt spiderling. So this one is finally going to molt after some time. Cool. And this one here, don't think it's gonna eat. Okay, so two more spiders and that'll be it. This one here is Sicarius thomasoides, formerly Sicarius terosus, the six-eyed sand spider. Beautiful, look at that. Blends in well, I love it. One of the more long-lived species that get up to about 15 years as females. And size, they get up to around 3.5 inches, maybe 4. Last but certainly not least is my Zenithus species Columbia blue, the blue bloom bird eater. This is Chitose. She is about 4 inches, confirmed female by molt, making her one of my most expensive teas I own, next to the Harpactera pulchropes. That is sexed. Let's see what Madame Chitose does. Nice, what a perfect way to end my feeding video. Sweet. Alright, as always, we'll get another clip of Haley and give a nice clip of Maggie as well.
Hey Maggies!
It's been a while since everyone's seen you. What's wrong, girl? This is my female Shih Tzu, Maggie Mae. Hard to believe she'll be 13 in May 10th. Such a sweetheart. And of course, some broccoli to Haley, my female guinea pig. Haley! Hey, sweeties! How can you really not love her? What a beautiful guinea pig. Alright everyone, so that is Tarantula Feeding Video 135. I do hope you enjoy it. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching. And I think next video, I think it'll come out on Tuesday for Garden to Tease. We're going to rehouse the big Coelobrachia species Cancrachan, the female Salmopoeus cambridgei, and the Formictopus species Full Green, since they're really overdue for a rehouse. And tomorrow is April 1st, so my first April 1st Oracle Fools video for you guys is Resident Evil 7. So I know it's going to take me a long time to record Resident Evil 7, and this will take me quite a while to edit, so I'm going to actually upload this video today, which is March 31st, so that way you can enjoy it, and a nice fresh start for April with a good back-to-back two episodes of Resident Evil 7. Alright guys, so keep watching.